Betway Premiership football clubs are all trying to do their last minute deals, getting rid of furniture that is not needed in their clubs and trying to bring new faces, new energy into their football clubs. Yes, I do go by the name of Askansi Football, discuss and engage on anything to do with football from Africa to the world and from the world to Africa. There are players that we wish, we pray that they would do well, whether they are playing for the football club you love and support or not. But from a distance, there are players that you can tell that this one is extremely gifted, talented. But because of reasons such as discipline on and off the field, lack of commitment that they've demonstrated over the years in that particular club, will obviously subject them to not being given minutes and playing for the football club. I mean, look at a case like a Sancho. A Sancho is a star. A Sancho is performing at the elite level for a Dortmund in Bundesliga Germany. He then is wanted by Manchester United, the biggest club probably in the world, maybe after Real Madrid. He then goes to Manchester United and things turn out sour for him. Today he finds himself playing for a Chelsea, gradually getting back to the old form, the form that we knew of him. I mean, these players, they move for different reasons. Euros came and went. Players like your Sterling, players like your Sancho, they were not part of the squad because they were not doing well in the clubs they are playing for. For reasons for players moving away from the clubs they were signed by, they will differ. And it is no different from the story I want to talk about even on this episode of Askansinsi Football. Now, story coming from Disket Times, Lorenzo, that is. And we all know, Lorenzo, he does not do these stories for clicks. And there's always smoke somewhere when Lorenzo has put up a story. Lorenzo says, Mamelodi Sundowns, they are interested in loaning out Sipho Mbule, the master chef, to Sekhukhune United. And how the article is written, it's almost like it is still up to the player whether he rejects the loan deal or he wants to fight for his position. Before I go into detail whether it will be a good loan deal or not, or whether he should reject it, let me just remind Sipho Mbule or his fans of what happened to Ekhuliso Mudau, I think over two seasons ago. Today, we're celebrating this Ekhuliso Mudau as the one of the best defenders, not just in South Africa, but in Africa. Ekhuliso Mudau, once upon a time, just after a season at Mamelodi Sundowns, they were ready to loan him out. And Ekhuliso Mudau, sailor that is, rejected and said, I am going nowhere. I would rather stay here and fight for my position. And look what has come out of Ekhuliso, who rejected that loan deal. Now, coming to Sipho Mbule, would I like him to stay? Should he go? If he goes, and he goes to Sekhukhune United, is he going there to add value or is he going to be an automatic starter? In that club, they've got good and decent players in the middle. You have a Thabang Munara, obviously, who plays a different position from a Sipho Mbule. Sipho Mbule is more of an 8, a box-to-box, as much as he can play a 6. But a Thabang Munara is more of a traditional sit-back, shield that defends DM or defensive midfielder. Mtambo is there. He's a 10 and a half. He's a 10. He can play also as an 8. He'll be going there to play with some good players. And here's the thing. Him leaving to go join another team where he might be guaranteed to get some minutes is actually good for him and being looked at better by a Hugo Bruce. The old man, I'm talking about Hugo Bruce, Bafana Bafana coach, he has shown himself to South Africans as a fair man. He has selected players from almost every club. If you do well for your club and he sees you fitting in his system in Bafana Bafana setup, he will pick you up. I mean, he selected players from Stellenbosch, from AmaZulu, and even an Ashwin Dodley, who's now playing for Kaizer Chiefs. He's playing for Bafana Bafana, not because of his exploits at Naturena or at Kaizer Chiefs. He He's been roped in to play for Bafana Bafana because of what he demonstrated playing for a relegation-bound Cape Town Spurs. So Hugo Bruce is a fair man. He selects players from every single team. If you do well, be rest assured, you'll be there. So one of the reasons why, if Sipho Mbule wants to see himself in Bafana Bafana, wants to see himself playing in AFCON, wants to see him give himself a chance and go to the World Cup, if that is Bafana Bafana qualifies for the World Cup, then playing at Mamelodi Sundowns with that stiff competition is still a risk. But if he goes out, there's a greater chance if he does well. Obviously, if he cleans himself from all these things that he's been tagged with of ill discipline, weight problems, and there's just so many things. So if he goes and he does well, he might be selected for Bafana Bafana because of the fairness that a Hugo Bruce has shown. But the other side is, and that is my opinion, is for him to reject the loan and say he will fight for position, and his story might end up being like the story of a Khuliso Mudau. Now, what will be the reasons for a Mamelodi Sundowns to get rid of a Sipho Mbule? Sipho Mbule is not really settled at Mamelodi Sundowns ever since he's been there. It's been on and off discipline issues, it's been weight problems, it's been, the list goes on and on. It's been injuries. I mean, coming to this season, he was not part of the preseason guys because he was injured. Starting the season, I think he was injured still. And so majority of his time at Mamelodi Sundowns has been spent in the hospital or trying to sort out issues that he had outside the field. I mean, he was one of the players that was also linked with a certain player that left Mamelodi Sundowns because of discipline issues. But I don't want to focus on that because he's young and we are all hoping that he really, really changes his mind and focuses on his bread and butter, which is football. He is not just called MasterChef because he left some nicknames or people like some nicknames to give to him. I mean, he's a MasterChef because he can really combine all types of ingredients and really dish out a meal that is enjoyed by the fans, by his colleagues, by his peers. So Sipho Mbule is extremely, extremely talented. Now, if Mamelodi Sundowns get rid of him, obviously Mamelodi Sundowns have been following the Jayden Adams of the Wine Boys, that is Stellenbosch FC, for some time. And these two players are more of box-to-box players, and Jayden Adams will also add value to a Mamelodi Sundowns. And also, Mangoma Mngwethi is really trying to put an imprint on this team, and he wants to say, this is my team now. I am the one in charge. So if he goes, chances are Mamelodi Sundowns are going to go for a Jayden Adams, who's also a disciplined, a brilliant, technical awareness top tier, a very good player who's also been chosen or selected by a Hugo Bruce. Now, Mamelodi Sundowns are also looking at shipping out a Semi Siabi, who's been in the books of Mamelodi Sundowns for probably now 4 years. From the time that Pito was there, I think he was the one that was signed by Pito, and then Pito left. So Semi Siabi, I mean, they're trying to clinch, agree on something so that he really goes and gets some game time somewhere else. Now, you look at the teams that are involved in CAF Champions League and CAF Confederations Cup, that is South African teams. Mamelodi Sundowns won 4-0 away against Mbabane Swallows of Eswatini. Orlando Pirates won away 0-2 against Johannesburg Galaxy of Botswana. Stellenbosch FC won 2-0 at home against AS Vita of the Democratic Republic of Congo. And the only side that lost their game away from home is Sekhukhune United, who were playing against a team from Luanda in Angola. And look at the signings that have been made in the Betway Premiership. Sekhukhune United have really signed well. I think it was just those glitches of changing their coach in the last minute. And getting a player like Sipho Mbule, definitely it will be a great value into their football club, provided Sipho Mbule stays fit and gets rid of these other tendencies outside the field, because he's a good boy. He's a brilliant soccer player. And I am hoping that Sipho Mbule rejects this loan and remain at Chloorkop to fight for his position. But him rejecting the loan deal would probably mean that Mamelodi Sundowns might not sign a Jayden Adams. But we will have to wait and see on this one. Because Steve Barker at Stellenbosch is already lining up a Xhumane Butsaka of Cape Town Spurs in the first division to bring him to Stellies. So Jayden leaves, he will sign Butsaka from Cape Town Spurs. I know Orlando Pirates, they are also looking closely at this one. Out of the four clubs I've mentioned involved in CAF, and of the big three in South Africa, that is Orlando Pirates, Kaizer Chiefs, Sundowns, I think Orlando Pirates is one club that has done their business early and they're probably okay now. Mamelodi Sundowns and the Kaizer Chiefs, their coach, their SD, sporting director, junior, have made it clear that they still want more players. They still want wingers, they still want strikers. They probably still want another DM. I don't know if they might also entertain an idea of asking Sundowns for a Sipho Mbule. Sipho Mbule going to Kaizer Chiefs, is there room for him in that midfield? Yes, there is. If a Sipho Mbule goes to Kaizer Chiefs, it's going to be great for the football club, great for the football fans. So, Mamelodi Sundowns, it appears like they are done with the business, but maybe they might be going for a Jayden Adams. We'll have to wait and see how this one pans out. But interesting how things are unfolding just before the 20th of September. That's when the transfer window closes. Yes, I do go by the name of Oscar. Don't forget to like, engage on the comments below, subscribe to the brother, help me reach 10,000. Oh, it would be nice to reach 20,000 subscribers by December. But the target for now is 10,000 subscribers. Really appreciate it, and I do attempt to reply all comments on the section below, whether they are negative or whether they are positive, because there are people that think that when we're doing the platform, we're doing them to fight them, even if there's banter here and there. No, don't take it personal. It's just that football is a game of opinion, so engage in the spirit of football. Don't fight, relax, calm down. I mean, thank you, but thank you for all the returning subscribers, people who always support this channel. I really, really appreciate you all, and I do not take you for granted. I leave it there, and by saying, may my God bless you all.